Welcome back to the Texas A&M AgriLife Research Center here in Bushland, Texas. We're out here in the field today. We're going to go over some of the stuff we've been doing. Kind of show you what we got going on here. We went ahead and got it all framed up. Went ahead and put the bottom ribbon board on, the footer there, and then the top ribbon board with the C-channel. So on the couple of things that we did different than we did on the first four, we took this and dropped it down a little bit because we're going to have a piece of metal strapping up here that's going to run those straps that we have. You can see on our other high tunnel here, that's these straps right there that run between the purlins. That's what we're gonna, we left a little extra room so we'd have some more meat to bite onto over there. So in the instructions it says a 1x6, we go with a 2x6 treated, that way a little bit more stability there. So we got our main post put up, and as you can see, we got it bolted in. So on all of our bolts and screws that we put in so far, we put some construction adhesive Loctite. Let me show you this stuff right here. We just put a little gob of that on the threads and then bolt everything together. That just keeps it from wiggling loose with the wind and vibrations and everything. So our posts are in the ground about 2 foot, and I got 2 80-pound bags of concrete holding them in. So we did that on all four ends there. So another thing I'm going to show you is what we're doing to kind of keep the structure down. We've had a microburst that came through when we first built them the last time, and it blew the side out of here. So what we have here, you can see down in there, there's a what they call an earth anchor. And so what we did, we just basically drilled a hole through the post here and the wood. We'll bolt that in. We'll put 4 of those on each side, 2 bags of concrete per, and that'll hold it down. That way if the wind catches the side of this thing, it doesn't pull all the posts out of the ground. So it's just a little extra structure. As you can see, we got all the joints taped. We use Gorilla tape instead of just regular duct tape like they suggest, because the duct tape, it just doesn't last long. Once you get into the weather and the heat, it'll just basically disintegrate, you know, within a couple of weeks or so. So we use the good stuff. It's more expensive, but it works. So we basically taped everything that the main cover is going to touch, and that'll keep it from rubbing holes in it. As you can see, we still got our strapping and everything on, keeping the structure straight. We've already drilled our holes, so once all these are drilled on both ends, we can go ahead and take our straps off and the structure shouldn't go anywhere.